Hello friends, welcome back to Skill Upgradation Series by CBSE Department at ABES Engineering College, Ghaziabad. This is session 2, covering basics of C++ and some object-oriented programming concepts. If we talk about the basics, we will cover about the historical part of C++, and here are certain points that we need to discuss. C++ is a basically general-purpose programming language that can be used to build a variety of softwares, system software, application software, databases, and other kind of softwares. It was developed by Bjarne Sundström at Bell Labs in 1979 as an extension of C language. Actually, C++ was initially called as C with OOPS, that's called Object-Oriented Programming System, and then later called to C++. So it is based on object-oriented programming paradigm. Paradigm is kind of model, programming model. Just like C is based on structured programming model, C++ is based on object-oriented programming paradigm or the model. C++ has the very strict standards, standardized by International Organization of Standards or ISO. It has various standards, C++ 03, C++ 11, C++ 14, C++ 17. 17 means 2017. So this standard was given in December 2017. So we have the different standards of C++. And then comes the very important part, because when we talk about the C++, mainly it is C with OOPS. So C is already understood by all of you or whatever who is going to learn this series. It's prerequisite, they must have some knowledge of C language. So we are covering the basic part of C++, that's an object-oriented programming model. We are not covering the basic part of C like loops, condition operators. So we are assuming you have done in C language. Here is what the object-oriented programming system is what. So OOPS stands for object-oriented programming system. So we divide this as a name suggest, it's a system of programming. What kind of programming? Object-oriented programming. So it's a system independent of any programming language to achieve a goal. Goal is what? Building reusable code to reduce the code size and increase efficiency of the project. Just take an example of C language. We have the structures. But in case of structures, we don't have any reusability. So whenever you are creating some structure, say support for employee, for student, for the faculty, we have always create all the variables again and again, like name, address, email, mobile. We always use printf scanf again and again for these members, because that do not provide any reusability. So code size getting this, the time of building project is high. But if you use object-oriented programming models, then we can build more efficient projects. Because this is a system, object-oriented programming system, and every system is always made of certain set of components. So OOPS provides is based on four core components. We call them encapsulation, abstraction, polymorphism, and inheritance. So whenever whatever language you use, that's an object-oriented language, is always at the four core components: encapsulation, abstraction, polymorphism, and inheritance. These core components also require three other components. We call them class, second one is instance, and third one is called reference. So based on these seven components, OOPS paradigm is based on. So if somebody will ask you what is OOPS, you can first define what is OOPS, then what is goal of the OOPS, what are the components of OOPS to start with. This is a basic theoretical idea about object-oriented concepts until we have the practical part of it. Then whenever you start with, because we have the three terms here, the class, instance, and reference, your interviewer will ask you these things. So you must be having some idea about these three things, or before starting any object-oriented programming, you must have the idea of first three things: the class, the instance, and the reference. So here is the first some definition of class. What is class? Just go through the definition first. This is a set of specifications or blueprint about an entity. Important thing is entity, about which we are collecting some data. You may have an example, say bank customers, you can have employees, you can have students, you can have books in the library. About we are collecting some information, that's known as entity. So what we do in this? So a class defines a set of specifications or blueprint about an entity describing all possible data members, also called attributes, and the methods, earlier we called functions, now called as behavior, also called as behavior also. So to be applicable on that entity. So that means what? Function, earlier in C we called functions, but in C++ we generally call it methods. C++ both the things, function and methods. Whenever we have something inside a class, we call method. Something outside a class, we call function. And they all have one other term, behavior. Your data member can other term, attributes or the fields. So what we can do, what is the purpose of class? So a class can be used to define multiple instances of same class. What do you mean? A class can be used to define multiple instances of same type. You can take the real world examples. We have a class called classic. Class is made of classification to divide something. We can have a class called human being class. We can have the map. We can have a model of a car. Based on human being, we can have so many human beings. Based on maps, we can build so many houses. Based on the model of a car, we can build so many cars. So a class defines basic structure or the specification or blueprint about the item that has to be built up. That's not available, but that has to be built up. So class is basically a set of specifications or blueprint about an entity. Getting the point? Then comes the point, what is instance? Your instance is the real item. It's the real entity created based on class specifications called as instance. For example, for one more thing, it's just like to make a house, we need construction process. We need a space and we need a construction process. Same way, to create an instance, we need special method that's called as constructor. So constructor is a very special function that will be discussed in the next few lines. We can take three, again, real world examples. A child, which is made of human being class. A house, which is made of map, based on map. A car, which is created based on model of a car. They're all examples of real instances. So to make a house, we need a map. To build a car, we need a model of a car. And to build a child, somebody we called God has created a class called human being class for us. So like this is, this we call instances. So instance is basically the real entity created based on class specifications. Then we have one more thing called reference. So whenever we create an instance, that goes to somewhere in memory. But we must keep the address of that particular instance. We call reference variable or simply reference. So reference, this is a variable which is used to hold the reference of some instance present somewhere in memory. So we can have three actual examples here. So we can have Aadhaar number of a child. We can have registry papers of a house. We can have registration certificate or RC of a car that represents, that holds some reference about that real items. So what we do, we call reference. So these are three real examples that we can have. What is class? What is instance? And what is reference? Now we go to inside a class. Then come the point, what are the different members that we can create inside a class? So a class has mainly two types of members. One can be the data members, other called methods. Data members can also be called as attributes and method can also be called as behaviors. Sometimes we call them fields also and the functions also. For the method, we use functions also in common terminology. Just like take in C language, the structures of the data members and the fields were the same thing. These methods again can be of two types. One is called special methods and general. Second one is called general methods. If we talk about the special methods, we have four types of general methods. There are four types of general methods. We can have constructors, we can have setters, we can have getters, we can have destructors. One is called constructor. Constructor is the first method to build something. Setter is to modify whatever data we have provided in data members, we can update that data. For example, your mobile number, your address can be updated in your bank accounts. Getter, to return certain value, so when you take the current balance in your account, that's getter. You want to execute some code when your instance goes to be from out of the memory. It's like we take a birth, this is a kind of construction. When we die, this is a kind of destruction. In between, we update so many things in our life, that's called setter. We take some value outside, that will get us. So a class can have four special methods called constructor, setter, getter, and destructor. Then come the point, what is constructor? Constructor has the three main features. So it's a special method inside a class with special features. First point is same name is class name. Second point is no return type. Every function has some return type, but constructor do not have any return type. Third point is to use to initialize data in data members. Constructor is very simple example you can see in the real life. When you go to bank to open an account, you need to fill a form. And that you provide some information about yourself. Based on that, your account is opened. Then you can do some deposit or withdraw. this is a kind of construction process. So account opening is a kind of construction process. Building a house through construction process, so again a constructor. What is setter? Setter is what? Special methods prefixed with set and used to update data, some value in the data members of an instance. This is called setter. Suppose you want to update a mobile number, we can say set mobile. Similar way, we can have the getters. Getters are used to return certain value. So special method prefixed with get and used to return value to the data members, like say get mobile, get customer ID, get balance, we call them getters. Then comes here one more important point called scope of members. So whenever you are creating a class, just like in real life, we can have three kinds of main members: private members, protected members, and public members. Take an example, we have some money in our accounts. This is very private to us. That money, when we die, that money goes to our children. This is called protected. There are some of the things which are available to the public guys. We call them public members. You can have some water outside your house for everybody, or so this is a kind of public that anybody can access. Similar way, class has three kind of sections in this: private area, protected area, and public area. So three keywords are given by C++. One, this the first one is class, to define a class about some entity. Then private keyword, then protected keyword, and public keyword, followed by a colon to define the area: public area, protected area, and public area. So if we define this members in these areas, private area is by default. If you not mention any private keyword, the area the member goes to private area. Private member accessible within the current class only. They can never go outside. Protected member means current class or in child class, and public member accessible anywhere. So if you want to write the class right now, the members right now, and to access anywhere, you want to access outside, they must be declared in public area. So class is done like this, and the, it should be followed by last in the semicolon, very similar to structures in C, use the semicolon in the last. And here we can take a small example for this. Here our test case is the bank customer. Our entity name is bank customer. Every bank customer maintains some data. It could be your customer ID, it could be your name, it could be a mobile number, it could be a balance. But to open an account and do some functioning in bank, you need certain things. Like we need to open an account, that's called constructor. We can modify our mobile numbers and addresses, we call them setters. We can ask the valuable in the available in our accounts. We can get our name, account number, customer ID, current balance, what we call them getters. Then we can deposit some amount, or we can withdraw some amounts. They're all functionality we can do on a customer. This is some idea. So thing is, how we can build a class to manage all these things, and then how we can access the data. See one small example. So first start with hash include iostream.h, then say conio.h, create a class. Class name is say customer. Define your data members, so they should not be accessible outside, so put a private area. Declare a members, say customer ID, name, then we can have mobile number, because on this mobile we are not doing any calculations, so we can put a mobile, like say, then we can have the value say balance, like this. So we have all these four data members. Now we can define public area where we can create the functions or the methods, because this is inside a class, we call methods. First method comes here is the constructor, and constructor's rule is a method which has the same name as class name, no return type, is called as constructor. Now we need to pass the parameters, say integer x, char star, say n, like this. And then this data has to be passed to our data members, say this opening amount or something. But one more important thing is, if we do like this, we have these data members and these are parameter names. So CID, in CID we need to pass the data of suppose x. But this is very difficult to remember the names, which parameter name has to be passed to which data members. Right now we have just four data members, but tomorrow in the big project we can have hundreds of data members. which makes a very difficult program to which data to be passed to whom. So better idea is we can have the same parameter name as a data member name. Say like name, say mobile, and say valence. What we can do, how we can differentiate that in cases? In that case, we have to pass the data of the CID beta member, this parameter name, to the data member name. So how we can difference? For that, it gives a keyword called this. This is this pointer. We get this CID equals to CID. So this CID is the parameter name which comes to here, and this data goes to from here to here. So this is basically special keyword, or say special pointer, which is provided by C++ to refer the data members of current instance available inside a class. Using this, you can reach to any data member. You want to copy some data, you need say strcpy, and strcpy again need a function, again need header file, sorry, what we call string.h. Say strcpy, you need to copy the data from say this name to name, then strcpy again this say mobile comma mobile, and then we can have this balance equals to balance. So role of constructor is what? Getting some data from outside and pass into data members. Now we can update some data, but updation, we can't update customer ID, we can't update your mobile name, we can't update your balance directly, but we can update your mobile number. So what we can do is set mobile. What we call this function is a setter, because it's going to update some data into some variable, some data member. So strcpy, say this, say mobile comma mobile. So this is what we call setter, because this is modifying the data and this is a constructor. Now we can return the values, say int get CID, return CID, get star say get name, return name, get star get mobile, return mobile. Then you have to get the current balance, say return balance. This is all set of getters and setters. What we call this is getter. When something is prefixed with get to return certain value, we call them getters. And to update some data, we call them setters. Now we can have two more methods to deposit and withdraw the amount. Say deposit. Some amount will be coming to deposit, and that will update our balance. So balance plus equals to amount. And when you withdraw some amount, you need to pass some amount. So it will decrease your amount, your balance. So your whole class is ready now. Just see this. This is a class. So we have the data members. We can have the constructor. We can have setter. We can have getters. Like that. Now we can have the main. Or say void main. Or we can create an instance of customer class, say customer X. X is a reference on here. So pay customer ID is 1234, name is say Amit Kumar, its mobile number is suppose say 981849501, and then opening amount is say 5000 rupees. Now we can see some data. See out. So say CLR and CR first to clear the screen. See out. say x dot get name to show the balance. We can have a cap, then say cx dot get balance like this. Now we save this program and run this program. Say demo.cpp. Now run this program. What happens? Nothing. Run this program again. Okay, some project is there, I think. Alt-P. Go to project. Okay, some project is already open, so we just need to close it first. Close all the files available. Open this file again. Demo.cpp. Now compile and run this. It's one error. Spelling of include is wrong. See this. Amit Kumar, 5000. If we deposit some more amount into this, we can put a line break also. And Alice, end of line. We say x dot deposit. We are adding some more amount, say 4000. Now again we see this is again duplicate. We say x dot withdraw. Withdraw say 1200 rupees. Now again, and we see the balance again, and we run this program again. See this. So after adding 4000, the balance is 9000. After withdrawing 1200 more, it's now 7800. All the function is going very well. So class contains a set of items that we can build. So a class has three segments: private area, public area, and protect not discussed right now, that we've discussed in a later part. This is the way by which you can simply create a class for any entity, and we can use the things like this. It's okay. Just do this, some practice, and learn this whole topic again. And we'll give you some next points in the next sessions. Thank you.